Welcome to the Energy Saving in the Home radio show here on KSEV, presented by Davis Air Conditioning and Heating, home of the Fixed Right Guarantee, by Carrier Air Conditioning and Heating Systems, turn to the experts, and by Water Furnace Geothermal Systems, better from the ground up. Our mission, cut your energy cost by 30%. Yes, you can do it, and yes, you can make your home more efficient. And yes, you can cut those energy bills by 30% by using the 30 steps to saving 30%. 30 great ideas. You can find that at energysavinginthehome.com, energysavinginthehomeradio.com. Download them. We talk about them here every Saturday afternoon here at on the Energy Saving in the Home radio show at 2 o'clock on KSEV. And we are broadcasting live from the 10th annual Fall Home and Garden Show. It's the Woodlands Fall Home and Garden Show at the Waterway Marriott. And in Woodlands, Texas, a great day, a great crowd out here at the Woodlands Home Show, almost 200 booths available for people to come out and take a look and talk to all the experts here at the Woodlands Home and Garden Show. And, of course, when we do these remote broadcasts from the Home and Garden Shows, we always bring a lot of different experts onto the radio show. And I'm pleased to have a expert, and also someone that also does a radio show on KSEV as well, Shannon Register with Register Real Estate Advisors.
Thank you.
And you guys do the 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock on Sunday. So if we got some listeners listening today, they want to tune in tomorrow, you're going to be broadcasting from the Woodlands Home and Garden Show as well tomorrow at 2 o'clock.
That's right.
Well, thanks for being here with us today. And, you know, what I want to talk to you about is energy efficiency. You know, we're Energy Saving in the Home radio. Let's talk about energy efficiency for a moment in regards to homes. And you're obviously a real estate agent and broker, and you're in the business. So what I want to know is, are people concerned about energy efficiency?
You know, some are and some aren't. It just depends on what they're looking for in a home. Some of them really just look at curb appeal and what kind of countertops does it have, what kind of flooring does it have. And then there are others that want to know more specifically how it's going to save money, what kind of energy saving features it has. They want to know what sort of appliance they are, you know, what name brands, what Energy Star ratings. And, you know, they get into the real specifics of it. So it really is just personality, I think. Different people are different. But there is a lot more demand for it now than there was a couple of years ago, that's for sure.
Well, we'll follow in the category. Dennis Seltzer is usually my co-host on the show. We have got him on assignment again this weekend. We always send Dennis out to find all the energy-saving ideas all across the state of Texas, actually. So we sent him over into the Hill Country to do some research, okay? So he would be really proud that I'm going to probably be the return on investment guy today, and then I've got you sitting in the chair talking about the pretty things in the house, okay? The non-return on investment items that still are very important to people. Mm-hmm. So, you know, just because we can go in and make things efficient, well, that reduces energy consumption. It makes the home more comfortable. It does all these things, but you don't want to live in a house with no windows because that's the most efficient house that I can put you in, right?
That's right.
So no windows is not good for you.
No windows is not good.
Okay. Got to have windows. I could just see Shanna trying to talk somebody into buying this home over here with absolutely no windows in it. I doubt that would even fly, would it?
I don't think so. Yeah, not in Houston where it's so hot.
Yeah, well, and the view. I mean, you know, we have a lot of golf courses, right, lakes. A lot of people want to have that view.
Absolutely.
Out the back. Mm-hmm. And that really makes a difference in their life. I mean, that's lifestyle.
Right. It is. You know, the backyards, we were talking earlier about how important backyards are now. People are doing the staycations. You know, they have the outdoor kitchen and the pools and the hot tubs and all the great landscaping. And there's so many features you can have out back. I mean, you want to see those from the different rooms in the home and really be able to enjoy them.
Right. Okay. But when you're talking to people that are buying homes, and so buying existing homes and new homes as well?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you're talking to them. Does energy efficiency really come up in the conversation?
Not very often, not when they're first looking, but once they find the house and they know that that's the house they want, then they get more concerned about those features.
So it's kind of, let's focus in on what the pretty things are.
Right.
And I tend to want to say that the wife and the family is the one driving that component. Is that
right? Are the bedrooms big enough? Does it have all the, you know, all the bells and whistles you've been looking for? Right neighborhood, you know. Once you find that, then it gets down into, okay, who's the builder, what sort of energy saving, you know, features are there in the home, how are the appliances on efficiency, you know. You start really getting it more specific into the green features of the home.
Okay, so am I right about the spouse scenario there, that the wife is driving most of that front-end component?
Yes, that is true. That is true. A lot of wives make decisions about which house to get.
You know, we talk about, the guys talk about man caves, and we've talked about that before with one of the remodelers that we've had on the Energy Saving the Home radio show, and we kind of came up with this concept that it doesn't have to be just a man cave. It can actually theoretically now be a man town.
Could be. And, you know, the media rooms, they're so popular. A lot of men make the media room kind of their man cave.
And so the media room, I'm thinking for a second now and thinking all that power that's utilized from the electronics in the media room. See, I'm doing Dennis's thing now, and it's like, okay, that's not making sense. But on the other hand, I usually play the other role and say, where the granite countertops are important, right?
Right, right. You know, the great things like granite countertops and wood floors, those are the things that make your home sell quickly. Mm-hmm. You know, that curb appeal, that gets buyers in it, and you find a buyer quicker. Mm-hmm. It doesn't necessarily give you a lot of return on investment.
Right. Okay, so, but we have to talk about that because that's the focus of the show, is the return on investment. But I that's okay. We can. Dennis isn't here, and maybe he won't listen, and he won't know. We just went completely off to the other end of the spectrum here, off the energy efficiency.
The great thing is that a lot of local builders are really incorporating green features into their build, and so consumers really have a lot of options.
Right.
There's some great features that really save you money on your utility bills, like the tech shield roofing. Mm-hmm. Lots of great insulation out there, and a lot of builders are showcasing those items to consumers. So there are some model homes where you'll walk in and you'll see. They'll have a wall built with glass around it so that you can actually see what's inside that wall.
Right.
Same thing with the attic, you know, so you can see what's in the roof. And that's a really neat feature that consumers enjoy checking out. You know?
Well, you know, talking earlier today as well about, you know, how some builders are more conscious about the building with the efficiencies,
right,
and some aren't. But the codes now requiring 2012 codes, and as we progress even further into the arena of the codes over the next, I would say, 3 to 5 years, I think all the new builders are going to be on board. They're going to be building with the mindset of energy efficiency. Mm-hmm. And I love what you're hearing, talking about the model homes, and you can actually walk in and see these things that are behind the wall that a lot of people just don't think is very important.
Yeah, and you know, when you have buyers who don't think about energy efficiency, it really makes them think about that, you know, and then it makes them question other builders and start comparing homes. And, you know, there are some builders who do minimum standards, and then there are some that go over the top, and there have been some who put so many green features in the house doesn't appraise, you know, because they don't take green features into
That's
much
right.
account when they're doing appraisals. So.
Well, let's talk about that, because as an appraiser is appraising a home, if somebody has put in that type of money for something that's more sustainable and energy efficiency wise, I've heard that there's a form of some sort that they're supposed to use to take that into account. Is that true?
Well, you know, I'm not an appraiser, but there are, when you look at an appraisal, I mean, there are ways to incorporate changes in on the condition line. You know, you can make adjustments. It really just depends on the appraiser, you know, and it depends on the upgrades. And sometimes you get credit for them and sometimes you don't. Mm. You know, if you've built the home,
yeah,
compared to the other homes in the neighborhood,
right,
you're not going to get all that credit.
Yeah, because that comparison scenario falls into place then. Efficiency, what would you say that in, let's talk about existing homes, kind of talking about new ones there. Let's talk about existing for a second. So as you're going out there and you're showing different existing homes, from an energy standpoint, what comes up after they've kind of zeroed in again, probably the same scenario, right? They kind of zero in on the subdivision, the house that they really kind of want in that subdivision, then do they ask for electric bills? Are electric bills given? Or
that is something that you can ask for as a buyer. You can ask the seller to give you the electric bills. And you know, everybody's energy consumption is different, though. You know, somebody can live in a house and have, you know, four people living there. Someone else can move in and be a two-person family in the same house. Your consumption is going to be different. Everybody has a different lifestyle. You know, one of the things that I think are great features that a lot of people do want are the thermostats that are programmable.
Right.
Another thing that they like to look at are the windows. You know, double pane windows are given usually, but when you start getting into some older resale homes, you know, you may not have that. So those are a couple of things that I see people